Let us now calculate the capacitance of a wire capacitor, which is shown here in this picture. Wire capacitor is a system of two parallel long wires, which are separated by a given distance D. And in this situation, the radius of each wire R is very, very less compared to the separation. And the length of wires we consider very large compared to separation, as well as obviously the wire radius. Now in this situation, I wish to find out the capacitance of this system. And for the same, if we transfer a charge Q from wire B to A, A will receive a charge plus Q and B will receive a charge minus Q. And if we consider the wires to be very long, the linear charge density will be lambda and minus lambda, where lambda can be written as Q by L. Now in this situation, if we wish to calculate the capacitance, then capacitance of the system C can be written as the amount of charge which is supplied divided by the potential difference VA minus VB. And in this situation, this potential difference we can calculate by using the electric field at a distance x from the axis of the positively charged wire. If this electric field, we can easily calculate the value. Due to this positive lambda, it will be 2k lambda by x. And due to the negative also, it will be in same direction, then it will be plus 2k lambda by d minus x, because the separation of the point from the axis of the negatively charged wire is d minus x, and both will be added up because positive as well as negative will develop electric field at this point p in same direction. And using this electric field, we can easily calculate the potential difference between the two wires VA minus VB. That can be given as integration of E dot dx. And that is integrated from wire A to wire B. And in this situation, we know inside the metal electric field is zero. So we'll integrate this electric field from the surface of this wire to the surface of the negatively charged wire. So the limits of x will substitute from x equals to R to x equals to D minus R. If we substitute the values of electric field, obviously a dot product we can omit because E and dx are in same direction. So it is 2k lambda by x plus 2k lambda by d minus x into dx, which is integrated from R to d minus R. On integrating this result, we'll be getting this VA minus VB is equals to, this will be integrated 2k lambda ln x, and if we substitute the limit from R to d minus R, it will be ln of d minus R by R, plus on integrating 2k lambda by d minus x, it will be 2k lambda ln of, if we substitute the limits from d minus R to R, it will be R upon d minus R multiplied by minus 1, because the coefficient of x is minus 1 here. Then in this situation, on simplifying this result, you can see we are getting it 4k lambda ln of d minus r by r. With this negative sign, we can take the reciprocal of the argument of this natural log, and then we can see both the terms are identical, that will be added up. Now in this situation, if it is VA minus VB, then using this relation, we can find out the capacitance of such a system, which is Q divided by the potential difference 4k lambda. We can write as Q by L is ln of d minus R by R. Q gets cancelled out, and if we ignore this R compared to D, because D is very, very greater than R, this can be written as, K can also be written as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, then it will be pi epsilon naught L upon ln of d by R. Or more precisely, we can also write d minus r by r, just I've taken an approximation. So this is the capacitance of this wire capacitor. We can also calculate the capacitance per unit length. For the same, we just divide this capacitance by L, and this capacitance per unit length C prime can be written as pi epsilon naught upon ln of d by r. So be careful about these results. as there can be many applications on which such results are used.